What is up, guys? It is Aaron from ilikegear.com, and today we are going to be doing our gear review on the Axis Thermal Hybrid Hooded Jacket from KUIU. So as always, this is just going to be a quick summary video. If you're looking for more technical details, we would suggest going to KUIU's YouTube. You'll be able to see all the stuff that they talk about there, which is much more advanced than anything we're going to get into. As always, for our members, we just tell them the stuff that we think they need to know and nothing that they don't. So again, we're going to go nice and quick and try to get this thing knocked out for you guys. Essentially, what this is a combination of two of their products. So it's going to be really easy for us to give the comparison guide video on this. As always, the if you want to try to win this jacket, the cost from them is $349. We are running our raffles on it. As always, what we do are reviews like you're about to see. You get a private one when you enter in this, which contains a little bit more details, but you also get an entered into a 1 in 20 chance to actually receive the item. Basically, what happens is $26 will be for one seat, and we sell 20 of them. So one person is going to win their choice of a KUIU Axis Thermal Hybrid jacket or the vest. And again, cost for that is $26. So that is what you pay for with that, but you also get a more in-depth review. So if you're into this sort of thing and it's a good chance to try to win one for some pretty cheap, as well as learn a little bit more about the item, you can do that at ilikegear.com. So let's go ahead and get into this thing. Like I said before, the cost is $349, which does sound pretty expensive for a jacket. But what we think they did here was they kind of combined two of their popular jackets. It is the Axis Hybrid Hooded Jacket, and that one is $300. This is their original. And then they combined the Elements, which is $259, and that's going to be a lot of the puffy that you see there. So if you're combining the two and the cost is only $349, then we feel it's a pretty good deal that you're getting in on that. They have all their normal colors and all of their sizes here. On this one, we are going to say do not size up. So usually with KUIU, we say you want to go one size bigger, especially if you don't like athletic fit. This one has enough stretch in it that it does feel good. So usually in my in the normal Axis, I wear an extra large, and this one I got a large and it fits great. It's super comfortable because the fit that you see here is stretchy, and usually in the Axis jacket, it is the armpits and arms that are super tight and a little bit up in the shoulder. So this gets rid of a lot of those problems. I would say as long as you like a little bit of athletic fit to not size up. If you like it looser, then of course you always want to size up with KUIU. So we're going to get into the weight, which is probably the next thing you want to hear. That is 23.3 ounces. So it's comparable to the other ones that they have. It's a little heavier than the normal Axis jacket. And then on the Elements hooded, which is pretty much what they did for the middle, it's a little heavier at 22, but it's comparable enough that if you're getting the Axis anyway or the Elements, that it shouldn't cause that extra ounce, wouldn't be too big of a deal. So the reason we say that they combined them is, as you see here, what makes the Axis jacket different from something like their guide jacket is they have the waterproof paneling, obviously on the hood, on the top, and then in the back where you're going to be sitting, and then on the arms. So that is completely waterproof material there, but the whole jacket is not waterproof. So if you're going somewhere where it's pouring down rain, you're still gonna have to put on something, you know, like their Chugach or a gale force jacket or something over top of this, as it's not waterproof. But if you're just dealing with a little bit of rain or you're dealing with snow especially, this thing's going to be great. And then this isn't super down material like you see on their Super Down Pro. Once again, this is more like the Element. So if you're looking for what kind of materials and stuff that is, you can get there by going here and just type in Elements and it'll show you this one. I like that they did this because the Elements jacket is much more durable than the Super Down Pro. So obviously when that Super Down stuff gets wet, even with their waterproofing technology, it becomes pretty much worthless. This one, I wear skiing and snowboarding and all sorts of stuff, and I never have an issue with it. And again, it's much more durable, so I'm glad that they use that material there. So those are the pros of it. I would say if there was a con, I kind of wish that they, and this is just a little thing, I kind of wish that they had reversed the patterns, you know, especially on this green. This is some bright green. I really wish they would have made this a little darker. You know, you're going to be out there looking like a turtle, but I wish they would have done the camo pattern here and then just done these layers, you know, wear up here instead. But I think the reason is because, and obviously I don't know, I don't have any more insight into this than they do or you do, but you can't get the elements in any camo pattern. So if they're literally using the exact same materials, then that would make a lot of sense why they're just using the elements jacket in the middle and they're giving you the Axis jacket on the outside. As far as how quiet it is, again, if you've worn the Axis or you've worn the elements, it feels like the exact same thing. So it's kind of loud. I wouldn't wear this. Obviously, whitetail hunting, I would not. Bow hunting, I would not. I would wear this, you know, Colorado elk, snow on the ground. This would be my new go-to jacket. It is going to keep me a little warmer, and it alleviates the need for me to wear a puffy, unless I'm glassing on the outside, on top of the normal KUIU Axis jacket. So I do like it, and it will have a place, you know, somewhere in my system as far as the weather and the conditions, but it's not going to be something that I feel like you could just wear, like the KUIU burner parka, where you can just wear that sucker all the time because it's completely waterproof and warm. This is going to have a certain temperature range where it's going to be either too much or it's not going to be enough. And again, you can go into their specifics and see where they say you should wear this. But as far as comfortability goes, I would say it's top notch. I love this thing. It stretches really well. As far as loudness goes, I'm going to say it's one of the more louder pieces, as both of those pieces already were, the elements and the Axis. As far as waterproof goes, this is your middle ground. It's not a waterproof jacket, but it is highly water resistant, being that the Axis has those panels. And again, that's what differentiates the Axis from the Guide in the first place. So now you're kind of just adding this onto the Elements jacket. So that way, if it does drizzle a little bit, you don't have to throw on a complete rain system. So again, this is brand new. We haven't had a chance to really even test it out much other than just wearing it out in the field. It's still 70 degrees when I'm making this review in Missouri. So we will have a more in-depth one where we can put it to the test, and we'll let you know anything else that we find. But our initial reaction is good. I think they did a great job on this as far as the purpose, how it looks. I think people are either going to absolutely love it. You know, you kind of look like Iron Man. Or you're absolutely going to hate it and think it's way too much as far as the flashiness goes, and so you probably won't buy it. But that's up to you. My personal opinion is if it works, it works, and this combines two of my favorite pieces, so I like it, and I think the price point, if you are alleviating, you know, that mid-layer or not having to use another puffy on top, if the temperature ranges make sense, then I think this price point is justified at $349. So again, if you want to learn more and get really into the, you know, the in-depth stuff, go to KUIU.com and then type in just the thermal. It'll pull this thing up, and then you can go down and read all about their descriptions, the features, and the details that you have in it. Again, this is just our little summary on it, and we will have more information for you guys once we're able to put this thing into action once the temperature ranges cool down. So if you have any questions, as always, post in the comments. If you have worn this thing or put it to the test, please post what you think in there. We are always happy to learn together. Again, this is just my personal and unbiased opinion. That's what we do over here at I Like Gear. We have no affiliation with any of these brands, and we just tell you what we think. Again, if you want to try to win this jacket, you can go on to ilikegear.com, and we have a ton of webinars here where we review and raffle off just about everything you can imagine. So let's say that you wanted to try to win, you know, a KUIU burner parka, which is an $800 item. You'd be able to get in once this goes live. You'd be able to get in for $37. And all of these are 20 seats, and we also do hunts. So we just raffled off a caribou hunt. There was only 100 seats on it. We've done elk hunts, etc. So if you're into raffles and you want to learn a little bit more, ilikegear.com is where you can do that at. But again, this was our down and dirty review on the Axis Thermal Hybrid Hooded Jacket. So I hope you guys have an outstanding rest of your day, and hopefully we will see you on the next one.